In this video, we're going to be taking a look at EyeMine, which is an interface that SpecialEffect has developed to help you play Minecraft using eyegaze. In this video, we'll be using the Tobii iX gaming eye tracker, but other eye trackers are supported by EyeMine. So before we get started, we'll check that the Tobii iX engine is switched on. And if this is the first time for a new user, we'll want to create a new profile and calibrate the eye tracker system for them. Once the eye tracker is set up, we can launch Minecraft. Because EyeMine uses a modified version of Minecraft, it's important that you select the Forge option here before hitting play. While Minecraft is starting up, we can now launch EyeMine. We've already configured EyeMine to use the Tobii iX, but if you need to change this for a new eye tracker, then you can find the options in the settings under pointing and selecting. EyeMine comes with four different keyboards, allowing different levels of access to Minecraft. Today we're going to be using the introductory keyboard, which has five large buttons on each page, but if you're a more advanced eyegaze user, then other keyboards are available with extra features and smaller buttons. Let's maximize Minecraft and start playing. At this point, we can play Minecraft using eyegaze. The first thing we'll want to do is to turn on Look with Gaze. And now when I look within the Minecraft world, it will follow my gaze around the world. If this is your first time playing, now's a good opportunity to ask somebody to use the keyboard arrow keys, left and right, to adjust the sensitivity. If it's moving too quickly, then use the left arrow to reduce the sensitivity or the right arrow to increase it. Once you're comfortable with looking around the world, we can turn on walking. When we turn this on, you'll see that at the top of the screen, a walking symbol has appeared. And now as we look around the world, it will follow our gaze and walk towards where we're looking. Again, if this is your first time, you can adjust the speed of this until you're comfortable using the up and down arrow keys. If you want to explore by flying, we turn on fly, and as you find obstacles such as trees and hills to fly into, this will automatically adjust your height and keep you flying up and over the obstacles. Now let's do some mining. Let's go to the second page of the interface, where there is a mining button. I turn this on, and you can see in the top right-hand corner, there's a mining symbol that tells me that I'm mining, and it will continue to mine until I turn it off again. So let's walk over to a wall and do some mining. Turn on walk and mining. As you mine more deeply, you'll find it useful to turn on night vision, which allows us to see either at nighttime or when you're deep in a cave. So now we've found a zombie in a cave, let's go and attack him. So for this, we want to turn on attack and turn on walking, and this will continuously attack until we turn it off. Once we've finished playing, we can turn off Look with Gaze and ask somebody with a keyboard and mouse to press Escape and close Minecraft. EyeMine can be closed by right-clicking on the keyboard interface and selecting Quit. That Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please contact SpecialEffect.